Hey viewers, welcome to my channel Movie Reveal. Today which movie we reveal that is Around the World in 80 Days. But before you start the movie, if you are new to the channel, please subscribe to the channel and press the bell notification so that our video can reach you first and we can be encouraged. And one more thing, it is not necessary, but you should like or dislike the video while watching. So let's start the video. Around the World in 80 Days begins at the Reform Club with Phileas Fogg, Thomas Flanagan, Samuel Palentine, and John Sullivan sitting by a fireplace reading newspapers. Passepartout, who is seeking employment, enters and Fogg begins to interview him for the position of servant. Passepartout is hired and he expected to begin work immediately. At the Reform Club, Fogg, Flanagan, Palentine, and Sullivan are talking about a recent bank robbery. This conversation leads to a wager. Fogg is quite sure he can travel around the world in 80 days, while Sullivan doesn't believe it can be done. Sullivan, Flanagan, and Palentine think Fogg is not considering the unexpected. All of the men expected the wager for £20,000. Fogg is to get on the train and start the expectation at 8:45 p.m. that evening. Passepartout, unaware of bet, is polishing shoes and wondering where Fogg got his money. Fogg surprises Passepartout, tells him to get ready for they are leaving to go around the world. Fogg tells Passepartout to pack only a few things. Everything else will be bought on the trip. Fogg gives Passepartout a carpet bag filled with £20,000. Fogg and Passepartout arrive at the Charing Cross station to get on the train. Passepartout is responsible for reserving a compartment. Fogg gives a short speech about being charitable and then he gives the beggar 20 guineas. Within a few days, all of London knows about Fogg's adventure. The public talks about the voyage and the press prints stories about an Englishman attempting to travel around the world in 80 days. The first stop is the Suez Harbor. Detective Fix and Consul are waiting for the arrival of Mongolia, the name of the ship. Fix is looking for the bank robber who took £20,000 from the Bank of England. The ship docks and Passepartout disembarks and talk to Fix. Fix began to ask Passepartout about his master, Fogg. Passepartout tells Fix that Fogg is wealthy and they are going around the world on a bet. Fix decides that Fogg is the bank robber and he sends a telegram to the police commissioner. In the meantime, Fix is trying to convince the consul not to stamp their passport because he believes that Fogg is a criminal. Fogg rents an elephant and gets his passport stamped. Fogg and Passepartout are on their way to Bombay. The elephant stops in the middle of the jungle, but Fogg and Passepartout still manage to arrive in Bombay 2 days earlier than expected. Passepartout wants to use the time to rest. Fogg insists they continue going. The 2 extra days should be saved. On the train to Calcutta, a conductor enters and tells Fogg that the tracks have ended. Fogg must continue on foot to the Allahabad station. Fogg meets the elephant owner again and offers to purchase the elephant. Fogg discovers that he has 12 extra hours and he dedicates those hours to rescuing a widow, Mrs. Auda. Everyone hopes on the elephant and they ride to the Allahabad station where they catch the train to Calcutta. Fix is waiting at the Calcutta train station. He calls a policeman to arrest Fogg. During the trial, Passepartout is found guilty of desecrating the pagoda of Malabar Hill and sentenced to 15 days in imprisonment. The judge thinks Fogg should be sentenced for being Passepartout's master. Fogg offers to pay bail and they leave. Due to a storm, the ship to Hong Kong is anticipated to arrive 20 hours late. On deck of the ship, Mrs. Auda questions Passepartout about Fogg. They get to Hong Kong 24 hours late and Fix there waiting. While on his way to tell Fogg that the steamer on San Francisco has been delayed, so they don't have to wait a week for the next one. Passepartout meets a Chinese man who gives him opium. Passepartout is carried on the SS General Grant by two police officers, and Fogg is never told about the steamer. The steamer leaves without Fogg. John Bunsby agrees for a large sum of money to take Fogg and Mrs. Auda to San Francisco via Yokohama. Fogg offers Fix £200 to assist on the boat. Meanwhile, the Passepartout wakes up on the SS General Grant and realizes that he left without Fogg and Mrs. Auda. A few miles from Yokohama, the SS General Grant lowers a ladder for Fogg, Mrs. Auda, and Fix. Passepartout attacks Fix for setting him up and making Fogg miss the boat to San Francisco. Fix explains to Passepartout that he's a detective and he believes that Fogg is a criminal. Passepartout agrees not to tell Fogg about the detective. On the way to New York, the train is attacked by Indians. Fogg, Mrs. Auda, Fix, and Passepartout arrives in New York in the hand car. Fogg notices a ship getting ready to leave. He goes over to the captain and asks him to take them to Liverpool. Captain Andrew Speedy says SS Henrietta is going to Bordeaux, and Fogg offers to pay him to take them. Fogg bribes the ship's crew with £300 to take him to Liverpool. The captain still refuses, so his crew locks him in his cabin. They arrive in Liverpool and Fix arrests Fogg. Fogg misses his train to London, but hot air balloon takes Fogg, Passepartout, and Mrs. Auda to London 24 hours ahead of schedule. Fogg wins his wager and gains a wife, Mrs. Auda. Here's the end of the movie. Now, viewers, you will enjoy the remaining movie clips. Stay with us, stay connected, and thanks for watching.